there's a lot of misconceptions about astronomy that we have to deal with on a regular basis when we engage with the public. How can we respond to these misconceptions in a way that's encouraging? While we can't always change those that are holding firm to their misbelief, visitors are often coming with a curious, open mind, not with hard-held beliefs. They're trying to engage with you. So think of it as a way of making a connection, a kind of conversational gift. And just like with a real gift, even if it isn't something you really want, you can still appreciate the thought behind it and say thank you. There's many ways to tackle misconceptions, from ignoring them to addressing them head on with the science. Each of them has their place, and it helps to know your audience. We're going to share one method here that many have found effective, and you can find more in the documents below. We call this method the yes and sandwich. First, even if this is a misconception that really pushes your buttons, take a deep breath and respond gently and warmly. Don't jump to "you're wrong," because that's not going to change anyone's mind. Start by repeating the part of the statement that's right first.
Some people think that the seasons are caused by the Earth's distance from the sun, and I can see why they think that. I mean, it's true with a campfire.
Then offer some information about how we know what we know. You can add a gentle correction or not. If it isn't that important, it's okay to let it be.
Did you know that we're closest to the sun in January each year? While it's summer in the southern hemisphere then, it doesn't explain our northern winter. Then I give them an easy way to remember what actually causes the seasons. It's the length of the days and the angle of the sun rays.
Then return to what you're demonstrating or showing in the telescope.
Here, would you like to see the sun safely with a solar filter?
This astronomer responded to the situation and encouraged the visitor's interest in astronomy. That's what we want to do. There's a lot of things that can interfere with a good viewing experience. So be sure that the language you use focuses on the equipment. The telescope needs focusing. A telescope needs a different eyepiece, rather than "you're doing it wrong."
I think for us particularly, what might be best is if you start like this, because everybody's a different height. It's always hard to have the telescope in the perfect position for everybody. Okay. So how about you put both your knees on here? Then you can put your hands right here, and that probably allows you to be nice and stable. You can hold onto the chair and then just kind of lean forward and gently look through the telescope.
I don't really see anything.
Here's an example of an interaction which isn't a misconception, but still needs attention. Sometimes when we're at a star party, we can see that someone has a blank look on their face after looking through the telescope. And you know that they didn't see what you're showing them. Let's look at how this astronomer deals with this situation.
I don't really see anything.
So go ahead and get close until you gently feel this. You don't want to squish against it. Just get close. And then you can move your head around a little bit if you have to, right? So maybe move it up or down a little bit, or left or right. It's kind of like trying to look through a straw, right? Imagine a straw. If you want to look through that hole in the straw, right, you have to line up just correctly with it, right? Except here it's a little harder because you don't actually see the straw, right? The straw is kind of hidden in the telescope. So you have to move your head around and try to find it. So give it another shot.
Okay.
So what's the misconception that really gets under your skin? See if you can apply this method. Can you find one part of the misconception that's right? It can help to practice with a friend. Just like scientists, visitors' understanding of the universe is evolving all the time. So we can either shut them down and ensure that they don't ask any more questions, or we can invite them to learn more.